Are you ready to get ahead of the curve? Well, on this episode of Tailgate Talk, we're going to talk about drywall domes and barrel vaults and groin vaults and undulating waves and how Armstrong FRAMEALL Curve Solutions can simplify and streamline and save you money on your next curve project when compared to slow and costly traditional framing methods. Now, here's two FRAMEALL items, the main runner and the RC2 clip, that you'll need to create any curved drywall ceiling application. A curved ceiling not only has a lot of radius options, but it can also have multiple curves happening in the same plane. With these framing challenges, our approach is to make it easy for you to curve your own main runners right on the project site or prefab the curves off-site based off of our shops for even faster on-site installation. Now, as always, we're here to help with your on-site curving so your project can be installed fast and easy. Just contact your regional Armstrong installation specialist or your local sales representative and provide them with all the applicable RCPs and section cut AutoCAD drawings that represent the radiuses you need to install. Our team will convert your project's radius dimensions into individual radius templates that you will use to construct jigs for easy curving of your FRAMEALL main runners. Once you have the templates, here's an example of how you'll use it to create your jig out of 4x8 drywall or 4x8 plywood. A plywood jig will retain its form better for larger projects. Simply mark off 6-inch increments along the 8-foot bottom of your template. Then measure up every 6 inches to plot your points while referencing each of the vertical measurements from your template drawings. Once you've plotted your radius points, screw a drywall screw into every other point, leaving just a little bit like a 1/2 inch of the head exposed. Next, drape a piece of 12-gauge hanger wire over your exposed screw heads and take a pencil and trace out your radius with a pencil. With a jig or rotary saw, cut the two pieces of plywood or drywall apart to expose your cut radius jig. Many contractors like to screw these two separate pieces to wall studs on site for easy jig work at a comfortable shoulder height. Feel free to modify your jig's design from how we did it. There's lots of methods. Just make sure to plot the correct points we give you in our drawing package. All that's left is to feed a flexible main runner into the jig for RC2 clip attachments. Your project's radius dimensions will dictate one of either two faceted FRAMEALL main runners that you will use. The HG8906FO8 has facets pre-cut every 8 inches and is used for radiuses that are 15 foot or tighter. The HG8906F16 has facets pre-cut every 16 inches and is used for radiuses greater than 15 feet. The top of each facet is held rigid for shipping by a little sliver of steel that you'll cut away on the job. This leaves a flexible main runner that you feed into your jig and then you reinforce it with RC2 clips and 4 framing screws per clip. The RC2 can be positioned with its peak up for concave radiuses or with the peak down for convex radiuses. Notice your cross T's location shifts from at the RC2 clip and convex installations, contrasted with in between the RC2 clips for concave installations. Constructing your radius with FRAMEALL means you're typically spacing your curved main runners 4 feet apart with straight cross T's in between. Now contrast this with traditional curve framing on 16-inch centers and you'll appreciate the time saved by curving much less material with FRAMEALL. Don't forget to reach out to your local Armstrong representative, your regional installation specialist, or distributor to get the ball rolling on your project's free curved shop drawings and radius templates. You'll save tremendous amount of time, material, and labor, making your curved drywall project a breeze. Follow the URL at the bottom of the screen for more information.